Thousands of years ago, they were once joined to the South American mainland, virtually an extension of the Andes. Today, these two amazing islands rank among the top 10 countries in the world in terms of species per square mile. Trinidad and Tobago is a land blessed with rainforest, sparkling rivers, and mangrove swamps. Home to countless species of birds and numerous flowering plants and shrubs, this is the ultimate eco-adventure. Accessibility is important, and this is where Trinidad and Tobago has a lot to offer, as all sites on both islands can be easily reached in a day's trip. So every day is a great day for bird watching, with a wide variety of ecosystems all coexisting in close proximity. The Twin Islands are part of the migration path for birds moving north and south. One of the most spectacular sights takes place along Trinidad's northeastern coast, where thousands of giant leatherback turtles make their annual pilgrimage between the months of March and August. The endangered leatherbacks migrate hundreds of miles every year, and while the males never leave the water, it is the female who will come ashore at night to lay their eggs, nesting up to 10 times in one nesting season, returning every 3 to 4 years for as long as 30 years. No visit to this land, the birthplace of steel pan and calypso, would be complete without watching the sunset at Carony Bird Sanctuary. Located in central Trinidad, just minutes from the airport and the capital city, time suddenly becomes immaterial as you wind your way through a maze of waterways. This is the home of the national bird, the scarlet ibis. Daily boat tours take visitors and naturalists on a winding river journey through the mangrove, where you can catch a glimpse of thousands of these birds brightening the evening sky. Nature truly unfolds before your very eyes. The Twin Islands feature many waterfalls, with the highest being Maracas Waterfall, just 15 minutes away from the historic formal Trinidadian Spanish capital of St. Joseph. Although it is a rugged journey, the sight of the fall is certainly well worth the climb. Another prime location is Avocat Waterfall on the north coast, which is well worth the half-hour trek into the rainforest, as the view is out of this world. A dip in the plunge pool is truly invigorating and will be remembered as the highlight of your visit. Professional and amateur naturalists make it a point to spend time at the Asa Wright Nature Center and Lodge. Truly spectacular and world famous with birders, the center is situated some 1,200 feet up in the mountains of the Northern Range. The Nature Center boasts 200 acres of forest filled with trails and tropical wildlife. The Pitch Lake in the southern village of La Brea is truly one of the wonders of the world. Discovered by British explorer Sir Walter Raleigh in the 16th century, when the oil and mud mixes with compressed underground gases and the oil evaporates, the substance combines to produce asphalt, the quality of which is among the best in the world. Not too far away, the Wildfowl Trust at Pointe aux Pierres must be one of the most unusual sanctuaries anywhere in the world, as it is nestled in the middle of an oil refinery and home to endangered species of birds and waterfowls. Another area of significance is the National Heritage Park at Shagaramus on Trinidad's western coastline, where there are a few offshore islands of great interest. The closest is Gasparee Island. This getaway is just a short boat ride over to the old whaling station. Gasparee is home to an accessible limestone cavern some 80 feet from the surface, where naturally forming stalagmites and stalactites are abundant. Come face to face with nature in Trinidad and Tobago, an ecological sanctuary.